Hey everyone, welcome back to the Preset Biz channel. So in today's video, we're doing a remake of I Don't Wanna Go by Tujamo. I think that's how you say it, let me know down below. Probably butchered it. And you don't wanna go anywhere because this is gonna be a sick remake. Let's go. So the bass on this song is actually quite simple. It's mainly got that Imambet character and I've got the perfect preset for that from the Main Stage Volume 1 pack and it sounds like this. And as you can hear, we've got a little bit of processing, so I'll run through all that at the end. So here's the MIDI for it, and I've applied about 30% swing. I've done some little tweaks in Serum as well on this preset. So where you have like the lower velocities, you've got like a softer cutoff on the sound as well, because that's what they had in the original. So here's what we have with the first preset on its own. The next preset I'm using is Blue Guard from Car Music Volume 3, and this is just one of those sounds that I use all the time. This is one of those sounds I'm always using in these remakes because it's so good for Slap House. And then we have Brazil Rare, which is bringing in this really noisy kind of vibe to the whole sound. So all together we've got this. And as far as processing goes, I've got some super minimal reverb on here where it's like 10% or 13% wet level. So it's adding an ambience. And then after that, we've got some BX Digital where I'm trying to pin the reverb to the sides. And then we've got some compression, pretty standard stuff. And then some OTT as well, which is just adding a bit more top end and just crisping up the whole sound. So let's take a look at the next sound, which is the brass stabs I noticed, which are super subtle in the mix. The way they've achieved this subtlety is by tweaking the filter cutoff, and you can do this in a fill in the piano roll itself. You can just control the note filter cutoff frequency and just bring it down a bit. So they're kind of muffled, and then you get like a big one on the third note. I'm really not doing a lot on the processing, I'm just putting a bit of reverb which makes it feel like less sampley. And then you've also got the sidechain that I'm using everywhere else, which is the classic chain. So next up I wanted to take a look at this really subtle plucky element that comes in on the second half of the drops. It's super minimal and there's a bit of sidechain as well, so you get that kind of suctiony effect on there. So this is how the preset looks. So these are all the elements we have so far without obviously any drums or effects, but this is how they sound together. So let's kick things off with kick number 23, the worst pun ever. But it's one of those kicks that's really nice. It's got a good top end and it's got a solid punch as well. Like most of the kicks in this pack are so sick for just cutting through in these mixes where there's like a lot of elements going on and like reverbs on the vocals. And then we have this really hard clap, which is super smacky, as you can hear. And there's also another clap section where you get these smaller claps that are sort of doing background percussive kind of elements, as you can hear. So next up, let's grab one of these hi-hats from the Main Stage pack, and I've taken hat number 2. So to accompany that, I've also got a closed hi-hat from the same pack. It's a super short hat, but it sounds like this. So I've also added this effect to that clap we had a minute ago, the 808 drum machine-y sort of clap. I've added some panning to it, so you get like a more of a transitional feel kind of style to the sound. And then as you can see, we've also got these crashes that are coming in on the starts of the drops and halfway through as well. So here I'm going to run through some extra effects we've got to do some fill sections on this song. And this was a fill that I grabbed straight out of the box from Main Stage Volume 1. And then it's also got like an impact, like a cinematic riser crash effect. So it just helps in the transitions. And then a stadium clap as well, because I wanted like a big final clap. And then to finish off the whole mix, we've got some really big impacts and noise exhausts, again, just to build up more ambience in the song and just really get the hype going. So that's the production side summed up. It's actually a fairly simple production in terms of sound design, but you've also got like a lot of drum elements going on. So yeah, let's go and listen back to the whole thing, get some build in there and see how close we got. So there we have it for the I Don't Wanna Go remake by Tujamo. I hope you guys didn't go and you stayed through the whole video. Smash the subscribe button if you're not already subscribed, and we'll catch you guys in the next videos.